you're an Amon Amarth fan, then you're familiar with ex-drummer Fredrik Andersson and his departure from the band. Starting in 2016, following his departure the year prior, the drummer started making statements about being forced out and ripped off. Andersson has released a new lengthy statement on Facebook in which he apologizes to his ex-bandmates. In the statement, Andersson brings us back to 1999 to describe a deal the band made in which every member shared money equally so there wouldn't be any conflicts from songwriting credits. In short, no matter how much or how little a member contributed, they would receive an equal pay. The idea was that the best material would always end up on the albums, no matter who wrote it. Unfortunately, most, not all of my riffs and ideas were rejected, but with this deal it didn't matter so much to me, and they were obviously rejected because they were not good enough. Fast forward to 5 years ago from today, that would be 2016, and it's been a year of fighting for Andersson for his royalty shares. I tried to claim my 20%, but I could not prove which songs I had actually written. The drums are not legally part of the music. Hence, I lost my share of the rights and had my name removed as songwriter. They did offer me to keep my share of the songs I had written riffs for, but being so few, I told them to keep them too. I don't regret that, but I do have to confess I never expected them to actually go through with removing me. They did. Andersson goes on to talk about how he was not hired but rather asked to be in the band and what that meant for him financially. I was never hired. I was asked to join the band when there was no income. There was no business. In fact, the first 5 or so years in the band, there was no income. The years 1999 to 2008, my average yearly income was $15,000 a year due to low income and lost income from my day job because of time off from tours, etc. No one in the band made big cash. After the band registered as a business, the payout to each member was kept low and funds were reinvested into the band. What this means exactly isn't made clear. What also isn't made clear is what happens to the rights if someone is no longer in the band. While this does create confusion, Andersson even makes a note about how he believes the band will have to adjust their shares in the future. Ultimately, he expresses an apology for the grievances caused in fighting what he calls a lost cause. Despite what feels like a resolution, Andersson doesn't relent about calling vocalist Johan Hegg a liar for his statements about him in Sweden Rock magazine. You can read the statement in full over at metalinjection.net, and let us know your thoughts on it in the comments below. This is Rob Menzer with the Metal Injection News Update. Be sure to like and subscribe for future updates.